And it's not that it's not like, it's just a requirement of the version of the software. And it's still fast.
Might have a chalk on her back.
The laptop that I've got, because she's the latest.
Excuse me.
This is kind of one of.
Yeah.
Leave it back by. Sorry guys, we had a bit of a technical hitch there. Ian spilt his cup of tea over the keyboard. And yeah.
Why is it always my fault? What have I done?
And the computer software decided to frazzle. So we are back and we shall get you up and running soon. Right. Wait 1 second, we should do a quick message coming out here. So just need to be out of share. So yep, okay, so we all seem to be working fine and
pass you back over to the professional team.
When are they coming?
Right, we are back, sorry about that. Oh, we're not back, I'm back. I don't know what Adam's doing. So I haven't missed much. One frame all, great clearance by Ray. In the previous frame it's Brad.
Yep. Sorry about that, boys.
I've not. I'm just giving Devin the mic. Oh, he's in the jam himself.
Oh, right.
Yes.
John Bevan.
John Bevan, yes.
I think we'll just end it there, shall we?
Yeah, absolutely. He's currently in Newcastle or Manchester watching the sleep.
Oh, okay.
With his lady friend. Good luck to you.
Romania, I heard you say.
It's Germany.
Germany, close.
Oh, yeah.
So how long? No, let's not go.
Let's
talk about the Pokemon.
Red's very favourable here at the moment because of the position of the yellows. Mm-hmm. I would be lucky. What would you say?
Well, I don't know, because the yellow that they're looking at now is blocking the red.
Yep.
The red middle on the left hand side is pretty dead, yeah, it's a double.
Yeah.
And the two down the end are not great, so reds aren't great.
Yeah. Either. It's subjective probably.
Well, they've obviously already chosen Adam. Key with it.
Yeah.
So it's my safety in reds.
Don't forget to like and share our stream. Get everyone back who was on before if you know they were watching. That would be fantastic.
So that's quite a clever shot there. He's trying to force him to move that yellow one in the corner. And I think you can just see the one over on the other side.
Yeah.
On the left hand side, middle.
He can get to that one, but I don't think there's much of a purpose because that bottom red. Use that to nudge the other yellow away. So there is a chance.
True.
There is a chance if we find the red is left on after the shot, but you know, I'm not in the foresight business.
No. It's definitely harder to commentate on pool and snooker, that's for sure.
Have you ever commentated on snooker?
No. Never will. Can't see the other end of the table.
I mean, yeah. There's so many gaps to fill, isn't there, as well, with commentating. You have to...
Very true. What he's looking at doing here, do you think he's trying to mark the red sign?
Yeah, I think he's just trying to mark the red sign.
That could have worked out better.
Could have. I think he probably just contained and pushed that red along the way, or use the white or whatever it is.
He's not going to leave any yellow, is he?
No.
Arcee's got the hardest ball to pot from the other side of the table.
Yeah.
Are you sure there's anything else he can do? He maybe nudge the red out on the left-hand side and just push the white close to the yellow. Or push him, but he's going to leave the yellow up in the opposite corner.
I think my choice of shot here is just full ball on that red he's closest to and leave the white there.
Yeah. Just make sure that red's on.
Yeah. Because it could be a double win because that red could then cover the right bag of the other yellow.
That's very true.
Hi Latham, welcome to the stream. Martin Latham.
Oh yeah, there's only one Latham in the world.
They're talking about Latham.
Yeah.
And what's your guys' preference between Blackport and IR? You can answer
good,
that one.
Good question. Well, do you know what? I'm going to be really honest. I don't care. But why can't we just have one? Because I think when it was World Rules and Blackport, it was very different because World Rules, I think, was considered quite negative, but that's certainly not the case with international rules. So I think that if we all move to one, I don't think it really matters. I personally prefer Blackpool just because I've played it more, but I've played enough international rules as well. I don't like the no totals in international rules, but I really like the skill shot, or not the skill shot, the loss of turn when you clear a covered pocket.
Yeah,
quite like that. So it swings around about.
Yeah.
Let's just go for one.
Yeah, go for one. I absolutely agree. I also think, that at some point, not any time soon, someone will invent another set of rules and we'll be having the same conversations.
Name's Lee Kendall, probably.
Yeah. Between international and whatever the new rule set is. You know, is there...
But then there'll be three again. And then one of them will go.
Blackboard will be gone by then, I think.
That's like very, very popular up north, and there's a lot of events up north. So I don't think Blackpool's going anywhere anytime soon.
But I also think you've got 15 balls, and there isn't too many ways you can mess with them to make a new rule set. So I think
don't know.
Yeah, someone will. Well, they might put an extra line of balls on the table.
Oh, that's unlucky, but. This table doesn't like pace, does it?
No.
You hit them at pace and they sometimes rattle.
It's a good question for you.
Go on.
What do you prefer? Do you prefer a Black Ball table, a Supreme table, or a Sam's Atlantic?
Sam Leisure.
Sam Leisure.
Well, I've got a Sam Leisure.
Yeah.
So that's probably a clue. I think that the Sam Leisures are really expensive compared to the Supremes and the Black Ball.
Yeah.
I think they're both very good tables. I really do. I think that Blackpool tables, you can get the choice of cushions. You can have them where, I think it's called Club and Elite.
Okay.
So one is slightly tighter pockets than the other. And I think that's what they use for county finals.
Separately.
Yeah. I mean, we don't notice a huge difference, but there's enough. They're just shaped differently, as well as being a little bit tighter. But Supremes are all over the place, aren't they? There's so many.
It's common, isn't it?
Definitely.
We have at the Golden Eight Ball, we have the Sam's tables, and it really is one of my favourite events. I'm not going this year, but yeah, the tables are lovely.
They are nice, but they should be. They're what, 2.5-3 grand now, I think.
Yeah, pocket change, you know.
Maybe for you.
Yeah, for me.
But the key difference. So on the Sam Leisure tables, they have a metal bar so that the cushion goes on and it's constant all the way down. So the bounce is better. Whereas on these two types of table, there are three bolts.
Yeah.
So you can get some irregularities. You get some areas where you say, oh, does it bounce? It's a little bit different. Well, it's a bit unlucky. It's a foul.
Black ball rules.
I think I definitely favour that as well.
Absolutely. I mean, two shots.
And this is the key difference between international and Blackpool, isn't it?
Yeah.
get a free shot, got to make the most of it.
Yeah, I mean, well, do you prefer the two shots? I mean, because if you're at a very good standard, two shots or ball in hand, I think, has the same advantage if you're at a decent standard.
We had a situation last night, it was in one of the Tunbridge Premier League games, where I think it was the black over the pocket, the red almost on it.
Yeah.
How can reds win? So it's over the corner pocket. And that's where I don't think it quite works.
It's like the international.
International, yeah. Because he can pick the ball up and put it anywhere, but he can't move the ball away. He's got to go for a double. How can you develop it and leave it safe?
Is that the same example where the black's over the pocket and so your final red is basically set?
Well, if you can imagine the yellow bottom left, that's the black, and your red is on top of the black, and they're the only balls on the table, but the white.
Yeah, because even if you do get a really good shot, then even though it's not really allowed, people are going to manipulate the shot to make it look like a valid attempt but not hit the break.
Oh, absolutely.
This is what I don't mind.
Exactly.
Yeah. And they will.
So that's where I think the two shot, or the one visit one, is going to hit that a little bit.
It's a bit.
Deceleration, perhaps?
Yeah. Hit and hope. Yeah. That's the problem, though. You can't hit and hope in those situations because you're going to knock the black in regardless.
Jack Harris. Long back for 2-1 lead. Is this marked it? But where's it going? Oh, he's covered the pocket.
Where's the cue ball
going? No, John, no.
It's unlikely from Jack.
His frustration, which is understandable, but I think he's come out okay. I think I'd like to clear these reds.
I think the most difficult ball is is in the top half of the table on the left.
The one closest to the back?
Not quite, because I think that goes. I think
Do you think it goes?
Yeah, this one.
I don't think it goes.
Usually we have a bird's eye view angle, but we don't have it tonight.
Well, I'm looking at the table and I'm pretty sure that doesn't go. It might look like it from there.
Without a ref, how can you call a valid or non-valid attempt?
Good question.
You can't, basically. Because it will just turn into who is the most stubborn. Who's just going to argue their point the longest? And that's essentially how it is, really.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But even if you roll up, you make a valid attempt, and you just miss the black, the guy's still no better off. You can't win. Apart from playing a double or treble.
What I thought is if you don't have a legitimate shot on your final ball to a pocket, then two shots should come into play only at that point.
Good idea. So this goes back to what you were saying about having a slight variation combining the two sets of rules.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
But you just know there would be some sort of...
See, that one doesn't go. What are you talking
about? Why is it out?
It's incredible. Well, now I think it's looking good. As you say,
you've got to be taking this to middle left now. I don't think you're going to get a better chance to get on it, if I'm honest.
Agreed. And then the one down the rail. It's just for you to miss it. I don't miss it, I thought so.
Yeah. I think you can just drop this in the plate.
Oh, it's missed. Yeah, as I say, they're missable shots.
And that's forfeit.
And 4-2? Oh, forfeit.
Forfeit.
That's 2-1 to Brad and Jack.
Sorry about the stream crashing, guys. We are down to half the viewers we was at, so hopefully they do come back.
So we've now got the next singles, which is Paul Shooter against Jack Harris. The last. last singles that Paul played in the semi-finals, he broke and dished.
Yeah.
Very nice clearance as well.
It was, yeah, very tidy. But he's a consistent player.
I've been on the receiving end of his broken dishes far too often.
Yeah. I think you would have anyone
yeah,
in those,
exactly.
Paul.
Very, very solid player, Paul.
Let's have
very
a look
good queuing.
Let's just have a quick look at our other angle and see how that's going to... It's a bit far away, isn't it? Let's see if we can zoom in a little touch. Let's get in there.
Oh,
where is the zoom? Let's ask you for that.
Adam is showing off his technical prowess.
It's very, very poor.
Where's Stuart when you need him?
Okay, start recording. Let's ask Stu if he could come over and just...
Swap temporarily.
Zoom the table for us. Sorry, should we have to zoom this table for us?
Yeah, in a second. I've just got the step ladders out.
Yeah. Use me if you want.
Right, yeah, guys, just going to get the step ladders out.
Yeah. Let's try and zoom this in for just so we get a bit of it. Touch more. Like I said, we usually have the bird's eye view, but we don't have it.
And now I've got 30 going, I need to get down to step ladders.
Let's go back to the main table. And we need to have a third shot, we'll go back to that one.
Okay, so, where's the action going this evening?
Yeah, it's alright. It's tip for tat in this final. We've said that about every final we've been up to.
I know.
What's going on?
But as in we're always commentating but never in them.
Yes. You should have been tonight.
Oh, no.
Well, no. 5-2,
no.
It's not really.
No, I didn't really, you know, I only had a couple of shots tonight. I didn't really feel the nerves, but I just, it just wasn't there tonight. I'm not taking it from the guys. I mean, every time I come to the table, they was cleaning up. There was, they played really well to really add up against us tonight, so... The worthy finalists.
Are you interested in watching your own stream back later and seeing how you feel?
Oh, sorry, was it all to me? No, not really.
Are we doing that at the end? We're going to analyse Stuart's game?
Absolutely.
Yeah, too right.
I think my computer might have another technical issue. Yeah, computer says no.
Do you want to have a chat with him?
Not really, I spoke to him yesterday.
I do need to go to the toilet, so you've got no choice.
Okay, we'll swap it around here.
Yeah. Musical chairs.
I'll jump over here. There we go.
Right, so here we are. Jack and Brad, 2-1 up. Jack on the yellows.
I wasn't paying attention. I was on my step there, changing the camera view. Where's Adam when you need him?
Pretty sure with four, I've seen him play a few shots.
Yeah, he's definitely on the list.
Cover the pocket though. What we do call Paul the magician.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You have to be in our team's best, so that's what I call him that. Bad things will happen to you.
He's been very strong this evening.
I think he's one of the most solid players in the league, to be honest. I think he's doesn't play many bad shots.
I think he just goes to...
And there we go.
Yeah.
And at least he's laughing at me, although the cue is coming towards me.
Never brought any of those shots out against me.
Whew, no.
But it's very warm in there.
Yeah, it's going to be warmer in the commentator's booth.
Oh, what's going on? Someone has said we'll have number one customary shots this evening. Ooh. I thought it would be chilly.
Yeah.
And you didn't want to see my little pins on my stream.
You did play shorts on one of those streams I saw.
Yeah, I always do. I always play really well.
Okay.
I think my legs are overeating.
Like your laptop.
Yeah, exactly.
he's gone for the triple.
He's gone for the triple. Great shot, thanks.
If you can see this one done by the blank, you should be able to be on one of these. What I think this is instant.
Yeah.
Half a second. This bit's going from channel suffering to ABS.
Yeah.
I think it's about half an hour, 50k resolution.
Exactly. Sorry, we're just talking technical about the software.
That's a nice
great shot from Jack. Just roll this in. The 3-1 lead.
Yeah.
And there it is. Nice clearance. Nice treble to start with that, Kent. So, Paul and Ray, bring some of the doubles magic they had in the semi-final to this, to get back into it.
Let's see if I can get a technical score board. Oh, no. Ah, that's why. Hopefully, wonders of the... Oh, there we go.
Have you done? Looks the same. Oh, you've updated the scoreboard.
Yes.
Well done.
Thank you. University, I went. That's another.
So, eight singles in this Brad versus Ray.
No, Scotch doubles,
no? Was it? Oh, sorry, Scotch doubles.
Yeah.
All the way talking to each other. Yeah, so Scotch doubles.
No, I mean, the ultimate pair of format is single, single, Scotch doubles, single, singles, but with this one, it's just awesome.
So don't forget to read the comments. See that.
Oh, blimey. Dave Rob. Hello, Dave. You have been active this evening. There's nothing else on TV for you to watch.
I like American-style table, but only because pockets are bigger. Well, Dave, I can tell you, I've just literally come back from America, where I played, my son lives there and plays in a pool league. The pool hall has got, we counted, 58 tables in it.
Oh, wow.
Some of them 7 foot, same size as this, and some of them 9 foot. Thing is that you would think when you bigger pockets, bigger balls, should be straightforward, but there's no safety. They don't play safety, because they can play with you. They jump over balls,
they
swerve down.
Yeah.
It's incredible. So it's not as easy as it looks. Good fun, though. More fun than this.
Heavy balls as well, aren't they?
They're much
balls.
Heavier. Yeah. Yeah. They're even heavier than snooker balls. Even bigger than snooker balls.
Oh, wow. So it wouldn't be no good with my 8.5 tip.
No. I think they're 12, 13 mil tips they use.
No way.
Yep.
They must
got 45 cues. One for the break, one for jump shots, one for swerve shots, one for everything, basically.
I'll have to bring my golf bag along.
they have 70 golf bags. Some are even on a trolley.
The things I find alien when I go from my playing cue to my break cue, which is 11 mil.
Yeah.
And it just, I just can't get used to it. It just seems alien when you're looking down.
Exactly, but you can't play with it. An 8 or 9 mil tip on those size balls. It's impossible. It's hard enough as it is. It may seem easy, but go and play someone half decent, it's not. I don't believe I have, Dave, seen you play, but go to the States, because there's a lot more money in American pool than there is here in the UK pool, that's for sure.
I can't even get the players right.
Well, it's true. Wearing very similar coloured t-shirts.
50-50 choice.
See, Jack's in very good spirits as normal.
He is.
Probably had about 15 shots. We're not talking on a pool table.
I was going to say, what, in this room?
Those two obviously on the side. I don't think either of them go. So maybe has he got the angle to go into the map? Probably not.
Sure.
Oh, he did have the angle.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it goes.
I think it goes to
the left one. Left one goes. I might want to screw back a little bit of this to make sure that he hits himself on the yellow in the middle. Do you think it goes? It's amazing how the angle on the camera does often skew the bottom line.
I think we need to get some strap some GoPros to their heads. So they can have some POV views.
Didn't Stephen Hendry do that on his podcast or his YouTube channel?
Yes, Martin. Still best in nine.
Cover the pocket though. And he actually missed on the left hand side, so you can clearly see the potting angle. Now Reds, how'd you take out Reds in stream? Reverse the question.
Oh, well, ask me.
Oh, okay. You wouldn't.
I'm so used to playing in smash box.
Okay, how'd you clear? I think, don't think it makes any difference in this particular case. No ball in hand, no foul. So what would you do international rules then, anyway? Get onto yellow? Not from here, obviously.
Yeah, not from here, but all right. I could probably take the one up the top left.
Yeah.
I'll take the one up the top left and go.
The trouble is, there's not many places for safety without yellow over the pocket.
No.
No, that doesn't help.
I mean,
next
can,
time.
We can, I'm just going to mess around with the camera bars for a second. I'm sure we can zoom in to see whether that goes. No, it's not going to send inside there, is it?
Really?
No.
I think you can hit, as we look at it, I think you can hit the left hand side. So you can swerve a little bit. But don't forget this swerve will push the white towards the right.
Wiz has just given me a massage, so
yeah.
It's very nice.
He's trying to make me quieter.
Looks like you've got power on you.
I know, it feels like it. Well, usually I'm quite loud, but I'm quite conscious that we are quite close, and when we're talking about shot routines, I just think they're just going to copy us, to be honest with you.
it's a bit distracting for the players.
It is.
That's why you need the commentator's booth. Come on, there must be a chippy in someone out there that can make us one.
What, a mobile one?
Yeah.
Take it around with us.
Cool.
I don't think I'll fit it in my bag for life from Sports Direct. Why are you whispering? Because we're right next to the table.
Yeah.
Plus the microphone was a bit too far away.
Who's whispering? Is it Stuart or me?
I'm both clear.
Both clear?
You're both clear now.
We're both clear. Oh, you're clear as well. Everyone's clear. Hope that's better, Carl.
you've got that red on the bottom rail that's the issue, I think, here. Thing with the yellow in the pocket though is if you screw down into that area to leave the red on the right hand side, you're not going to go in off. So if they can get a nice potting angle on the one on the left, that's definitely an option.
Mm. I think they're maybe look to play the one over the pocket, then the one in to the middle on the left. As we're looking at the
middle.
Yeah,
then where are they going? How are they going to get onto that last red down the bottom? Because the one over the other side is only taking you to the right side of the table and left.
The magician.
He is a magician.
We shall leave it to this one. No,
it doesn't always
exactly
work for magicians.
No. I think this is where I usually come unstuck when I'm at this stage. It's just thinking which shot to take.
Well, I think the white ball control is the key, isn't it? It's what the good players do so well. It's on a piece of string. I think if he pots this thing, he can bring the white for the red on the left-hand side of the table to do what I say, to screw down to the bottom. Not the right angle.
If he leaves the white around this angle and takes this one, would it be a natural angle for it to come down?
Yeah, you've got to avoid the yellow there in the middle of the table.
Yeah.
It's risky. And then you've also got to get back up to the slightly tricky pot in the top corner.
When
what the magician does.
Yeah, when in doubt, always take the easy one.
Oh, yeah, too right. Especially in doubles. Try to get out of that one. Yeah,
that's unlucky.
Unlucky. Still got the shot his head though. It's a bit harder now.
There's no shot clock this evening, guys, because it's only a race to five.
Was it
22-11? Okay, we'll implement one in the last frame. I do feel like I've got a parrot on my shoulder.
I know.
We've got this new super duper mic coming with this telescopic boom arm.
Sounds good.
Yeah, that should be good. We'll just turn the volume right down on it so you still can't hear us.
Exactly, yeah. We've never solved the problem. While we wait for them to decide, did I read somewhere that there's another money match event on? Is it May the 4th? Is that right?
That's right, yes. Saturday, May the 4th. We're running another Money Mayhem Day.
Money Mayhem.
Money Mayhem Day. Mm. So we've got I think we have got the three main event slots filled now. We're not going to disclose any of that information at the moment.
Just write it on a piece of paper.
We don't want to disclose that at the moment, but we will be taking those, putting those out to the public shortly.
Are they going to be shorter races, please?
All of them will be shorter races, as requested by the referee.
The referee?
He was very tired at the end of the day.
Need another referee. Come on, guys. Somebody must be a qualified referee that's prepared to give some time to us.
No, exactly. That's like we always say. We're doing this for the community and you guys. If you want to come down and you've had a bit of experience with a referee and you want to come and ref, come on down and have a ref. If you want to come down and do some commentating, come and do some commentating.
Yeah.
I mean, it gives me a break. Even though I do love doing it.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, lucky.
Can't get the microphone off him. That's our Stu. perfect angle now for the red.
Cole Jones is with it already. Yep, may the fourth be with you, Cole.
Yeah, yes. Star Wars Day.
Yes, excellent. That's why I named my son Luke.
There we go, Chris Byrne, you've been volunteering.
Exactly.
Does that make me Princess Leia, is that right?
Yeah, exactly.
So, they get paid, don't they, these refs? What, £20 for the whole day? That's £10 if they share it.
£20 and a can of Diet Coke.
There we go.
And you might get a free lamb shawarma.
That's worth £20.
Yeah.
And so it's a century, so we know that much, do we?
What's that, by the shawarma? Well, you could get a takeaway.
The
next event is going to be at Century
Money
again.
Mayhem.
Yeah, Money Mayhem Day we're going to be having.
More money on the tables, I think, from what I've heard. Give them something, Stuart.
One of the matches has increased from last time. We're not going to give much away.
50,000, is it?
Oh, 50. Lira. Yeah, it's for quite a hefty bucket. You know, I mean, I wouldn't really put money the way the guys will put money out for playing. I couldn't justify it, really. Not really. I mean,
me neither.
£2 on the lottery ticket's enough. But yeah, if you want to come down and be on the undercard, we've got several tables free. If you want to line yourself up with an opponent, arrange a money match and come on down. You'll get your you'll be given live updates throughout the day.
Oh, what's this yellow in? I think the long black, the 4-1 lead.
Yeah, I think he's just
going.
Bit
of top cushion if he wants to. But
yeah, I'll probably play this just in top left. Or am I looking at it wrong? Or was it the inverted camera? Yeah, did I? Yeah, I'm not too sure. I don't think
there it goes.
Yes.
Well,
it's definitely got a hold of that one.
Top right doesn't work now.
No, top left
on
there.
Go top left.
Yeah. Should we have a player's cam switch over?
That doesn't work.
Not really, does it? We'll come back to the mainstream.
You've got more events before then, haven't you? April the 20th, Wednesday League singles.
We've got a few coming up. We've got next Monday, I believe, we have the women's final in Centuries with Jan Spiller. Yeah, I'm not too sure of her opponent. My partner will tell me shortly.
Julie Midgley.
So that one will be live streamed.
Both coached by Sean, I believe.
Is that Mr. Halligan?
Yeah, it is.
Right, so yes, that one will be 8 o'clock next Monday, live streaming that event.
Mm-hmm.
I believe the following Monday. Oh, he's just gone in off.
Oh, he's lost the white.
Yeah, I believe the following Monday will be the pairs final, where the other half of Wisejack will be participating. And then we have April the 20th, which is down at the Paddlewood Club to do the Tunbridge Wells League.
That's four that. Tables in the main arena. It's quick fire. It's not long races, so hopefully get some six red shootouts as well. Be good fun. Come down if you want to. Plenty of space. There'll be plenty of space in the main arena.
Yeah, we've got four tables going into the main hall, so there's loads of supporting space. If you want to come on down and have a look.
Invite only.
Mm-hmm.
Now all full, everyone's paid. So, what do you reckon here? Surely you've got to leave the red at the top till last.
Yes.
If you roll it in, you cover the pocket. If you miss, you're not going to miss that. So Surely it's just about getting on this bottom one in two shots.
I think I'd be inclined to roll the red in the middle to the bottom right as we look, and or somewhere near the pocket, and then clear the two at the bottom, and like you say, leave yourself an angle for the red up near the black.
Yeah.
It's always easier said than done.
Oh yeah.
I wouldn't play it from there on the cushion though, by two shots. That's right, Dave. 22nd doubles. So Wisejack will be there. I shall be commentating. If someone would like to come along and join me in the designated booth at Centuries. Yeah, Dave.
Dave said he wants to commentate. I think.
Did he? Has he said now? Oh God, I've lost. Let's have a look through his chat.
Might be there for a while.
Good old Dave.
Oh, Carl Jones asks, "Is Blackpool rules?" Yes, it is. Mm. Oh, somebody already answered. I'll be too slow, Stu.
Oh, do you know, I was like that the other night. I was chatting away and not even reading this. My partner was reading it.
Can we be careful with the use of the word partner, please, Stu?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I did think that. Thank you, Adam. That's
I meant parrot.
Yeah, yeah, I was thinking. He's got one eye.
Colleague, yeah.
I'd like to be known as co-beneficiary.
Might have to explain those words.
Right, Dave, I'd just like to say thank you very much for clarifying the dates. It's not next Monday, it's the 15th and the 22nd that we'll be streaming live at Centuries.
That was always the danger with that. Easy to not get onto the one on the bottom, and now you've got that problem.
I'll be playing Division 2 matches both nights. What can we say to that?
Good luck.
Yeah. Good luck, Dave. Good luck. I'm sure we can have someone else pop along and commentate.
Bill Rose.
Yeah, Bill's always very forthcoming.
Partners. No, we can't say partner then. His partner's there. He'll bound to be there.
Yeah, we'll be there watching.
There we go.
When you mean partner, is that Adam Wisby or someone else? Yeah.
I don't really mind you calling what you like.
Okay. Looks like it's going to be a
4-1.
Yep.
Nice back.
4-1 it is. They're on the hill.
Why do we say that? On the hill. Must be Americans.
Is it Jack and Jill? I've got no idea. God, I've never thought that far ahead, to be honest with you.
That's
This is the problem when you have finals and you don't have the organiser of the event here.
Yeah, where is he?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Is he doing some other work?
Well, I'm sure when you get to this stage, it's then you just reverse the singles again. But you know, the guys are happy just to sort it out on their own.
It seems faster on the camera than it does on the table.
Well, they're very close.
Very good lag.
Should we zoom in with the camera?
No.
Okay.
It always goes wrong when you zoom the camera.
Can we not see in the wonky view?
Oh, go on then.
Let's have a look.
Yeah, that's you know what?
Let's have a zoom in with the wonky view camera.
Should call the ref. Oh.
From your side.
It looks mine, doesn't it?
100%.
You
right? Thank you, that's okay.
There you go, multitasking.
Definitely right decision there, there's nothing in that.
Yeah, so they're not lagging again, this is just an instant replay we're doing on the computer software.
That's why they picked up.
Dave Robb reckons it was a left-hand ball that won the leg.
Which left?
Yeah. Where were you looking from the table? It's an inverted camera.
From one side? Yeah, it was
if you can hear loads of whispering, guys, it's the crowd.
And if we had decent cameras, we could pan round for them.
Just kidding, Stuart, just kidding. God. We're in trouble now. Adam's playing with the settings.
Mm-hmm. I've already been through the... I mean, Dave's got a good point, actually. We should have a VAR set up for VAR, yeah, for lagging, just in case we ever get into this situation again.
I think it's called a ref, isn't it?
Yeah, it's called a ref.
And where is Ash tonight? I thought you signed him up for the year.
Isn't Ash's birthday today? Or which Ash we're talking about?
Ash Walker, not Dunlop.
Oh, Ash Walker. I don't know where
he is. You wouldn't want Ash Dunlop.
No, you wouldn't.
You'd be out every 5 minutes with a cigarette.
What I'll do, Dave, is I'll bring my tripod and my laser level next time and set it up. We can project it straight across the table.
There's a chance of ball. Yellow go, I think it does. You see on the camera, it doesn't look like it does.
No, it doesn't.
The table, it does. I'm sure of it.
Little containment shot there.
Yeah, I think he didn't have a cushion. So, foul. One shot with, is it? And I think that could be the...
Yeah, the... Paul's called a foul on himself there.
Wouldn't expect that to miss this opportunity.
Well, if you're watching people, and you've probably noted that this isn't our standard scoreboard which we use for Wisejack. We just... implementing a secondary one this evening just to see what it's like, and we shall be going back to the other scoreboard. this is one my 10-year-old grandson threw together this afternoon.
I like it. I like the verses. It's snazzy.
Yeah, we got. Well,
and also, you said Wisejack, isn't it? Wisejack. Mm. Nobody calls him Wise. He's not Wise.
No. Well, we're gonna. He's a wise old owl.
Well, he's not wise, he's not old, and he's not an owl. Apart from that, you're correct.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's not really him who's part of it.
Well, you can only see Jack on the logo.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he's slowly being faded out.
Right, so middle, corner. What do you think?
I think he's going to be taking this one and coming down the bottom.
Nicely played.
I have to wear these spectacles to look at my computer screen, and every time I look over at the table, it's all blurry. I need bifocals.
That's right. Great position.
Yeah, nice to play.
Does it go back up?
It's nice to see Brett's partners watching him.
Yeah, I can hear someone on the phone. Oh, yes, it's Jack.
I think he's at the bar.
No, he's on the phone.
Oh, is he on the phone? Yeah, I think he's got a bit between his teeth now. It's a nice shot.
Got to be a bit careful here, because he's going to go down to the bottom. Be careful, he's still on the other end.
Jack has just entered the building.
Negotiated his new partner for next season.
Yeah. His current one's not doing too bad.
No, they keep leaving him. No chance. And loyal to Liam.
Oh, are we talking about Paul, not relationships?
We are, because you didn't say partner. Still get it. Two good pots. And Jack Harris is in the diaper.
This one.
Great pot under pressure.
Yep.
Very nice shot. Just the back of the title.
There she drops.
Off the knuckles.
Excellent.
Well played. That's it. Jack Harris defends his title. Brad wins it for the first time. Well played to the both of them.
Yep, excellent result there. 5-1. So Brad and Jack are our current Ultimate Pairs pool winner for the 2023-2024 season.
Just solid.
Yeah, very well.
Final, very solid. And had chances, took them. That's what you got to do.
Yeah, they play very well. Very well. Knowing that he was playing for a pack of Chris and a Twix. Yes.
Yeah.
His composure was excellent. But
and now we're seeing the true professional on the table.
Yeah, he doesn't know that we're still alive.
Is he presenting the trophy?
I'm not too sure what he's doing. I think he's...
He would have cleared the yellows.
Yeah, he's just saying this is why Stuart shouldn't have been playing tonight and he should have been playing.
Yeah,
I don't think he knows that we haven't stopped the stream yet.
No, we could still commentate though.
Yeah, no, exactly. If he'd have cleared that. He knows if we... So he's just realised we're still live. But...
well done. Well done to...
Well, thank you.
Commiserations to Paul and Ray. Good final.
Yeah, and thank you yourself, Ian, for coming along.
No problem at all. And if not before, see you on the 20th.
Yep.
You're playing as well, aren't you?
I am playing. I qualified.
And paid.
I know, paid. One of the last to play. Yeah, paid, exactly. but it's all paid up. I'll be there on the 20th. But
perfect.
Excellent. Well, thank you guys and girls for joining us and watching us this evening. So that was the conclusion of the Ultimate Pairs double for the Tunbridge Wells Pool League on the Wednesday night. So great result for Brad and Jack. Commiserations to Paul and Ray. They did look very good, both of them, in the semi-finals. And Brad and Jack seem to take it one step further in the final. So thank you all for watching, and both myself and Adam will be signing out.